How to make a 3D coffee cup in Adobe Illustrator, a vectormade.com tutorial. Hey guys, Kerry Hawkins here with another vectormade.com tutorial. Today we're going to talk about making 3D objects in Illustrator. I'm going to go ahead and do this coffee cup here that I grabbed offline. I have done some work for some coffee roast card things that are going to be used at a restaurant that's inside of a furniture store. So anyway, I want to make a mock-up 3D model of what their logo might look like on a coffee cup. So let's jump in. So first thing we're going to do is grab an image. Here I've got the coffee image that I'm going to make a model after, and I'm just going to use this as a reference point. So what you want to do is lock your reference image. I hit Control 2 to lock it. So now I can't select it. It's not going anywhere. That's good. And then come over and grab your pen tool. And what you're going to do is just make a flat version of the coffee cup. So imagine you're looking at it in a two-dimensional space. You can't actually perceive any depth. You're just seeing the height and the width. So as you can see, the image has a little bit of depth to it and is tilted. We'll get to that later, but just make it flat. So I'll start somewhere in the middle here, and I'm only going to make half of the object, and then we will revolve it around to make the rest of the object. So click somewhere in the middle, and then click straight out, and then maybe come down at a slight angle here. And then let's go ahead and make this a solid angle for now. We'll come back and fix it in a sec, and I'll show you what we do there. And then just bring this back in, straight line, another straight line, and then back to center, and we're aligned with this first point. What I would do then is go ahead and switch your stroke and fill, and then color in the black to white, because the color of the cup is going to be white. And then you want to select what you just made, come up to Effect, go 3D, and Revolve. And then I would click this to front for now, and then just go ahead and click Preview. And as you can see, it's all funky, because we're starting from the left edge. We want to change this from left to right edge. Boom. Now you got a coffee cup, right? Or at least the beginnings of what we're going to make. On this, let's go ahead and tilt it by, I believe, -7 worked really well. Yeah, -7 degrees worked great for getting that similar kind of look, adding a little bit of 3D perspective to it. And then, as you can see, it's a little bit choppy looking, a little like boxy, because the number of blend steps is only at 25. You can bump that up to 255. It will eat up a little bit more of your processing power, and it might slow your computer up a little bit, but it looks so much nicer if you can do that. The other thing I would do is the surface shading is usually set to plastic. You can do wireframe, which just lets you see through it. Say you've got that reference image and you need to still see it, you can do that. Or diffuse shading, which I think looks better for this application because it's kind of going on like a matte coffee cup, and we don't want it to be too shiny like it would be with plastic. It's like, ugh. So, and then you can, of course, come in here to, this is like your shader of your for your lighting, and you can drag this light around. So if you want it to be on the left side, and you can shade it that way. Your light intensity is at 100. If you lower that, you'll see that the light becomes dimmer. I want 100. And then ambient light is sort of the darks around it. Like, how dark do you want the darkest spots to be? If you want a little more ambient light, then you will bump that up. And I think 75 looks pretty good here. Another thing you can do is actually add another light. So click this middle button here, and you add another light. You can drag that around to the right side if you want, or you can, you know, put it up above or something like that. I like to put this in the back. So click on this button, and it moves that light to the back side of your object, which just helps kind of get a little subtle glow to the edge here, like the light is behind it, hitting it, and kind of bleeding over the edge. And I kind of like that look a little bit on these objects. You don't have to, and there's probably even a better way to do that lighting, but, you know, just get it to where you want it to look, you know, pretty decent. I like a couple, maybe a third light every now and then go. Your default shading color is going to be black, and for a white cup, that's going to look good. You may have to change that depending on the color of your object, though. Just keep that in mind. And then go ahead and hit OK. We're done as far as making that goes. What we want to do now is I'll go ahead and move this by clicking Control Alt and 2 to unlock anything that's locked. I will move the reference photo over and we'll make a few changes based on what this looks like. So first thing we want to do is put a little indentation up at the top. See how it kind of like comes in slightly, just slightly lower right here, like a circle. So, you know, grab this object, go ahead and get the plus add anchor point tool by hitting plus. So that's the hotkey, plus. And then just make like two extra anchor points right there. So let me go to wireframe mode and show you. Here are the two extra anchor points we just made. And you'll want to grab this line segment and drag it down. So I'm in the middle of the two points and I'm dragging it down. See, I just created an indentation. Boom. And actually, I think that looks pretty solid right there. I would just go with that. That looks pretty good. What I would do next is maybe click on this. Again, with your direct selection tool, clicking on that anchor point, you will get this little circle. And then you can click and drag to give this a radius. So probably, you know, about like that, to give that a little bit of a radius. Next thing I would do is maybe give these two points a very subtle radius. You know, just to give them a little bit of a curve here, because it looks like that's curved a little too. And then I'll do the same thing for this bottom. I'll give this just a little bit of a curve. Lips in just slightly, changes the shading ever so slightly. And then the same thing with this bottom one, I'll probably do that too. Just a little something so that it looks like it's curving in under itself and gives a little bit of a shadow line edge at the very bottom. I think that looks pretty perfect. In fact, I'm just gonna go ahead and get rid of this, okay? Let's delete that layer. Next thing, if you wanna keep everything white, you can keep this as is, but I wanna actually do like a different color top. And so I'm gonna make two versions of this. I'm gonna like copy this so that I have the whole thing. And then I'm gonna use my direct selection tool, come in and just delete the bottom part so that all I'm left with is the lid. And then I'm gonna Control F to paste to the front, boom. And I'm gonna double click to go into isolation mode. There we go. And I'm going to grab all the points that are the lid and delete those. So now all I've got is the cup, the bottom part. So send that to the back. I'm hitting Control Shift and left bracket to send it all the way to the back. And I've got my two layers now. I've got the lid and then the cup below. So we can go ahead and color this lid however we want to. And I've already got these two colors I'm gonna be working with today. So I'm gonna give it a red cup for now. And it's a stroke, so just color in the stroke with whatever color you want. And boom, it auto updates to whatever you just chose. So, and then for this part, I'm going to add a graphic to this face and have it curve around the cup. So I went ahead, I've already got a logo that I'm working with, and I put that logo together with a bar of color behind it. And then I'm grabbing all of this to make it one, you know, one selection. Come over to your symbols window, click and drag those into the symbols window and just name it something, you know, coffee logo. It is a graphic and it's going to be static, and then just hit OK. All right, so that's in my symbols window. You can see it's been added here. Next thing you want to do is select this, go open up your appearance window and double click on revolve, or rather single click on that. Go ahead and click preview to make sure it shows back up, and then click map art. Now you'll want to find the face that has that you're looking at, right? Because you've made a three-dimensional object, so it's got multiple faces that you can put stuff on. But we're not going to rotate this around, so we really just want it on the face we're looking at, which is this sixth one for me. Then you come over to your symbol and click down to where you made that coffee logo or whatever you were going to use. Go ahead and click OK. it places it kind of in the center, which as we can see here is kind of like all the way on the right edge, centered on that right edge. Well, we want to click and drag it and bring it over to about here, and then maybe expand that out just a little bit so that it looks proportionate. And we might have to just drag this out a little so that the circle does not look too bastardized. Let's see. I mean, I think that looks decent right there. If you wanted to have it offset slightly, you could have it offset slightly. And then I would click Shade Artwork, because it will take what you just put on there and use the shading that you used on that object. So we want it a little darker on the edge here and a little brighter right here. So if I click that, you'll see it should update. And it does, it is slower, it'll say slower. So just keep that in mind if you've got a really complex 3D object you're making. And then click OK. And there is our object. So we've colored in the coffee lid, and here's the cup, and you can present this to your client to say, hey, do you want to get some of these made? Another thing you might do just for fun, let me throw this little tip in there, is to grab your ellipse tool and make an ellipse that's like slightly bigger than the bottom here of your cup. Let's go ahead and color that in with black, and we'll move it all the way to the back. Again, control shift left bracket. And let's just drag out this point, this one anchor point, maybe come out a little further like that. What we're gonna do is then grab that and go to effect and blur, add a Gaussian blur, and just preview that to see what it looks like. Actually, I don't wanna do a Gaussian blur. Let's not do that. Let's do stylized feather. That's gonna end up looking a little bit better. So there we go. And actually 0.4 looks really good. So 0.4 inches, hit okay, boom. You have a nice little shadow that looks like it belongs in the space. I might actually bring this up just a little bit so it's not quite so harsh on the front and on the left side here, because that's probably where our light source is gonna be in this imaginary world. So something like that looks really cool, right? You can present that to your client and say, hey, here's what your logo looks like on this 3D object. So let me know what you guys thought of that tutorial. If you've got any questions, if you've got any things you'd like to see, like, subscribe, comment, share, do all those wonderful things, and I will see you guys in the next video.